allocation of resources.
This is perhaps another version of a purity test, but I'm curious, what would need to be true or what facts would have to emerge in order to change your mind on some of these topics and maybe not become a crypto maximalist anymore? You say, you know what, maybe this is not going to have that much of big of an impact and I shouldn't spend that much time on it. What do failure modes look like here?
I would say, like, if there's some fundamental heretofore undiscovered security issue, that's the kind of thing which, and what I mean by that is not something that can be patched, right? But like a theoretical new class of attack that renders, you know, all these different kinds of blockchains like infeasible, or you can constantly attack them and update them in a bad way. That would be the kind of thing which would, you know, make me say, okay, you know what, I thought this was a secure way of building things, but maybe it's not. I think that's hard to do because we've now got a diversity of different approaches to updating blockchains, but it's possible. So that's the kind of thing that would make me question whether that future was real.
Yeah, I think there's a technological failure cases. I think that you could have, let's say, a Bitcoin or something like that gets used in like a horrible terrorist attack. And you know how the government is, like, any excuse to grab power. Like after 9/11, we got the Patriot Act. Patriot Act gave us all these kinds of abuses, including NSA surveillance of all of our activities for the rest of time. I could see politicians overreacting and blaming all of crypto and basically cracking down on next-gen internet, in which case it sort of flees to other countries and it kind of goes underground and still gets developed. It just gets developed elsewhere more slowly.
How should governments be responding to all this?
Well, the governments are in a little bit of a, they may not realize this, but they're in a little bit of a race with each other. The United States is extremely lucky that we have the reserve currency of the world today. And we're extremely lucky that Silicon Valley is parked in the U.S. It's not luck. I mean, a lot of it is due to good policy, but we're lucky that good policy.